no clue what's hidden in the depths. Please be careful.
We just have to go through it, right? It's no different from our normal job.
You can expect radio interference further on. Assess the situation and take appropriate measures. You may commence.
Sure thing!
Origami reinforcements are being summoned. You're in danger. Suggest changing battle points.
Sometimes.
We're waiting for you back home. with secondary targets and is in pursuit. Affirmative. West. Emergency situation. Unexpected large Aragami coming in quick. Entering the area now. No more options here.
Doesn't feel like depths as much as it does a hideout.
It certainly is ideal terrain for staying out of sight.
Could the Crimson Queen be holed up here?
Huh?
Well, Hilda, is there a chance? It's just perfect. The radio's on the fritz.
This is really thick.
You gonna be okay? Doesn't this mess with normal God-eaters like you?
Yes. However, even accounting for bias factor specialized for the Ashlands, we can't linger for any longer than is strictly necessary.
Well then, we'll stay as long as we can.
Huh? Wait.
What? Are they Aegis?
The Crimson Queen.
Long time no see, bro.
Is that you? Neil? What are you doing with the Crimson Queen?
Neil? Is this the little brother you were telling us about? The one that went missing?
Just listen for a bit, okay?
If you've made it this far, then that means your mission is nearing its completion. Success is not far off. Congratulations.
So, you're Werner?
In the flesh. I am Werner Gatelin. I'm the founder and leader of the Crimson Queen.
And what business does the Crimson Queen have with us? If you plan on hurting my comrades...
I don't want any violence. I'm here to talk. Hear me out for a moment.
Go on.
What we've built here is a nation of Aegis. It is a place where we can live as human beings, free from the burdens of class and discrimination. Here, we have left the rot of the outside world behind, and we are building a land of principles.
And going around setting off ash storms? Exactly what sort of principles are those?
It is true, though regrettable, that some of our members could not overcome their desire for revenge against their former owners. You should understand. You should all understand. And who can blame them after being treated in the despicable way that Aegis are? You may hold me responsible for their actions. Though I failed to stop them, I do not support what they did. Vengeance only breeds more vengeance. However, now we have finally struggled free from the chains of hatred. Now that we have a safe haven, there's no reason for conflict.
How is it that you can live out in the ash like that? Even Aegis can't stick it out long enough to live in it when the levels start getting this thick.
It's because we have bias factor made from the humanoid origami cells. Thanks to its properties, we have near total resistance to the ash.
From that bastard Inukai?
Yes. We did become concerned when this cover with Gleipnir was compromised, and we lost access to the supply. But now, we have what we need. We do not forgive those who have persecuted and continue to persecute Aegis, but neither do we seek their destruction. We simply wish to create a paradise for ourselves, one where we can make our homes and live out our lives in peace. A place where people can be born, live their lives, have their own children, and pass away. That is the underlying purpose we seek as part of the Crimson Queen. We know what you've been doing. You are Aegis, but you've managed to grow so strong that even Gleipnir cannot ignore you. I ask you, will you not lend us that strength?
Hugo, this place they're describing... What they're saying is...
I have to admit, it does sound like a lofty goal.
Come, be a part of it.
Sorry, but I'm afraid you'll have to ask someone else. We have a job to do.
And you? I'd be curious to hear your thoughts. Do you agree with him? Very well. then we will wait until you can give us your answer. Fenrir HQ is further ahead. You shouldn't have much trouble reaching it. But beware of the Infernal Lord who sleeps there. I pray for your victory.